of the function, Professor Jagdish sir, the honorable vice chair. Guest for today's event, interaction session, Venerable Chairman from Taiwan. Yesterday I met her and I came to know about the meaning of her name, Gateway to Enlightenment. Sri R.T. Gaikwad sir, former Secretary, Government of Maharashtra, my friend Sri Praveen More, Superintendent of Police, HOD of Aryan Buddhism, Dr. Prashant Pagari sir, Dr. Madhuri Savan, all guests. Last 8 days before I received a call from the Honorable Vice Chancellor, Professor Chopra sir, that Sri Gaikwad sir is coming to the university along with the Venerable Chairman for a visit. And as they are establishing a Pali University proposed in the agenda, they would like to visit our university. And the Vice Chancellor, Professor Chopra, specifically told me that you give a presentation on the Buddhist caves. Usually we call them as the university caves. Before starting the presentation, I would just like to give a brief. Our registrar has already mentioned about the university. Before that, our director of BCOD, Professor Patil, has also briefed us about our university. It was established in 1958, 23rd of August. On 14th of January, 1994, it was renamed as Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar Marathwada University. We have a campus of over 700 acres, 42 departments, thousands of students, and we are the A-grade university in the state of Maharashtra. And fortunately, we are the first in the rural Maharashtra. And the Times, they have mentioned us in the list as the 18th university, ranking of 18th university in the country. And we are progressing ahead under the leadership of academic leaders, Professor Chopra, Professor Jagde, Professor Patil. So we are moving ahead. So today, my intention is to tell you, as you are the citizens of this region, Madam is from abroad. So why this university is here? Why this university is in this campus? So most of us, we have known, we have read, we have seen the ancient universities. We say that Nalanda or Takshashila is the first university of the world. So Nalanda, Takshashila is there, Ujjain is there, Vikramshila is there. So we have a number of universities in the ancient times. Where, just to give you an example of this Nalanda University. In Nalanda, there were 7,000 professors. And the students, they were over 35,000. It was a residential university. And students from all over the world, right from the Roman Empire, the Greco-Roman, the South Asian, Asians, everybody used to come there for seeking the knowledge. This was the ancient past. Now we know about this, and on the other side, we know that we have the Gurukuls. In the time of Ramayana, Mahabharata, we have seen, we have Gurukuls. Gurukuls are meant for the teaching. Universities are meant for the higher education. But there is a missing link. Now as your students, many of the students are sitting here. Higher education is there in the universities, and the school education, it is always there in the Gurukuls. So where is the graduation, undergraduation? So where was it? So through research, we have found that the missing links appear in the caves. Like we have the caves of Ajanta, Ellora, and we have over 1200 caves. 1200 caves in present India. If we count the ancient India, it is more than 2000. So 1200 caves in India, out of that 900 in western Maharashtra, western India, and 800 in Maharashtra. Now these caves, they are not merely the caves or the Buddhist caves, not for the religious purpose. The purpose of excavating a cave is very different. The caves were primarily meant for the Varshavas of the Buddhist monks. During the monsoon season, the monks had to retire for 2-3 months. So they are going back to the caves. That was the system prevailing in the Jains and the Buddhists in the ancient past. But the important purpose of the caves, it was to provide accommodation to the ongoing travelers and traders. So the travel and trade is going on. Like it is, like to give an example of our region, traders came from Rome. They are coming till Aurangabad and going to Paithan. This is before 3000 years ago. And when these traders are coming, they have the ancient trade route. And all this trade route are located the ancient caves. So this was one of the purpose. Second purpose, very important. These are the centers of learning. These are the colleges and institutes of that time. You might be wondering, or nobody wonders, like how the caves were excavated. Now for the layman, for the common man, we say that the caves were excavated by the people with a chisel and hammer. Is it true? It is not true. It is not only chisel and hammer. Chisel and hammer means channi atoda. Yevda sadharan kaam nahi hai. Then what is it? Now, to excavate a particular cave, we need the design. I have to tell you that today we have a computer, supercomputer. We have Param, supercomputer of India. We have so many supercomputers throughout the world. Even today, we cannot recreate the cave of Ellora, that is the Kailas temple, which is carved from top to bottom. It cannot be recreated today, even after having all technology. The caves, they were excavated 300-400 years. Several generations of the artisans, engineers, architects, they worked for excavating a one single cave. So what kind of technology that they had? So it is basically the architecture, the designing, the engineering, the technology. Then comes the artisans. Then we have the arts, painting, sculpture, and so on. So all these things, they were taught in these particular caves. And we had 1200 caves. We had 2000 caves in ancient India. So these are the centers of learning. Means these are the institutes and colleges and universities, small universities of that time. And fortunately, we are sitting here in this beautiful campus of Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar Marathwada University. And in this university, this is the only university in the world, as our Honorable Vice Chancellor Professor Chopra, he always tells that this is the only university in the world which is having the caves in the campus. And to tell you more about this particular campus, this campus, it is not ancient, it is more than that. During the Chalcolithic era, that means during the later Stone Age and early Bronze Age, people used to reside here in this particular campus. And this is found, this evidence are found in the campus of the university. Several stone tools have been found. These are kept in the ASI. So people are living here since thousands of years. We can calculate 7,000, 10,000, 50,000. So since that time people are living here. But the main aspect is before 2000 years we have these caves of Rajtadaka. So I will go to that presentation to start. Now here you can see a Google map. The map is showing the location of the university campus and the caves. Please move ahead. Now here you can see, now in this particular Google map, some things are reflected there. Bibika Makbara you can see. Above that, the last part, you see some buildings are there at the last we find the caves, the mountains. And on the right side we find Himayat Park, Udyan. So now during the ancient times when these caves were excavated, and the name of the city, there was a city, a small town named as Raj Tadka, or the other name is Raj Taluka. And the evidence is there. Here you can just see that there is a water body. Right now it is the Salim Ali Sarovar. But if you see that, it is starting from the mountains, from the eastern side of the Aurangabad cave. So this water body was there and this has been mentioned. Next slide. This is the aerial view. This is through a drone camera, this image has been captured. This is the Aurangabad caves known as Raj Talka in the ancient times. An aerial photograph. This is from the western side. Move ahead. This is one more photograph which we have taken from the campus. Next. So this is a rock cut inscription. नीचे सांगितलं पुरावा असायला पाहिजे ना. या ठिकाणी अनेक लोक आहेत. तुम्हाला मुद्दा पण मराठीत सांगतो. इतिहास बदलण्याच्या गोष्टी करतात. औरंगाबादला 400 वर्ष झाली आपण ते साजरं करतो. चतुर्थ शताब्दी, 52 दरवाजे, 53 दरवाजे या गोष्टीवर आपण अडलेलो आहोत. दिस इज नॉट ट्रू. बिफोर 2000 इयर्स वी हॅड दी एन्शियंट सिटी नेम्ड एज राज तडका अँड Raj Talka, two names are given, and there is a evidence. Literally, evidence is there. This is a rock cut inscription. Manje, like Shila Lake. This rock cut inscription is found in the caves of Kaneri. And here you can see that it is mentioned from the path, ancient trade route going to, we find a place named as Raj Talka. The cave of Raj Talka, where a donation is given by a couple for the making of a koti and a kudi. It is meant specially for the monks. Koti and kudi sati then dan kelela. Ya danacha ullekh kuthe aahe? Kaneri che lene madhe. Kiti varshapurvi? 2000 varshapurvi. Mhanje yacha artha kay? 2000 varshapurvi ya thikani kay hota? Raj Talka navacha gav hota. तर त्याला आपण शहर म्हणू. आणि तिथे एक तलावाचा उल्लेख आहे. तलाव तुम्हाला आधी दाखवलेला आहे. तो आता छोटा झालेला. सो दिस इन्स्क्रिप्शन टेल्स अस अबाउट द एक्झिस्टन्स ऑफ दिस एन्शियंट सिटी. नाउ व्हेन दिस एन्शियंट सिटी इज देअर, सो नेक्स्ट पार्ट इज दॅट इट इज नॉट ओनली द केव. बिलो द केव वी हॅव सीन देअर ऑन द वेस्ट साइड अँड ईस्ट साइड. ईस्ट साइड वी हॅड द लेक. ऑन द वेस्ट साइड इज द कॅम्पस ऑफ द युनिव्हर्सिटी. We had the people who were staying here. A full-fledged village, or sorry, town was there. एक छोटं शहर या ठिकाणी अस्तित्वात होतं. आणि त्या ठिकाणी आपल्याला एक मोठं असं विद्यापीठ त्या ठिकाणी अस्तित्वात होतं. म्हणजे डॉक्टर बाबासाहेब आंबेडकर मराठवाडा विद्यापीठ 58 साली जरी स्थापन झालं, तर त्याचं ओरिजिन कधी आहे? 2000 वर्षापूर्वी या ठिकाणी एक विद्यापीठ अस्तित्वात होतं. हा त्याचा पुरावा आहे. मी अजून 2-3 पुरावे तुम्हाला दाखवणार. नेक्स्ट. नाउ दीज आर सम ऑफ द स्कल्पचर्स. दिस इज फ्रॉम केव नंबर 2 ऑफ औरंगाबाद केव्स. नाउ दीज आर नॉर्मल स्कल्पचर्स फॉर एवरीबडी. इट इज ओनली फॉर द हिस्टोरियंस. दे कैन इंटरप्रेट इट. आपल्याला इथे काय दिसलं? व्हॉट वी सी इन दिस इमेज, इमेज ऑफ बुद्धा इज देअर. बुद्धाज इमेज इज देअर. But we concentrate on the last part, at the bottom of this sculpture. We find certain people are there, the laymen. They go like that? They are the laymen. They are the people from the surroundings. They are people from Raj Talka. And they are praying to the Buddha.